Spoilers alert to follow. The movie begins in a train station, where Joe, a train guard, is patrolling the area. He receives a rejection letter and angrily crumples up the paper and throws it in his locker. Just then, the train supervisor arrives on the scene and announces that one of the guards is ill and can't do his job that night. Joe complains about the situation, arguing that he's tired and has just finished his shift, but the supervisor encourages him to do the job. Meanwhile, Ellen enters the scene in the background, making Joe think that the consolation of doing the job is being able to spend more time with his unrequited love. Joe quickly makes up his mind and commits to the night duty by boarding the train. Joe greets all the passengers and starts checking tickets, asking for the ticket of a blonde she can't find. Although initially annoyed, she quickly takes her money and pays. As he continues his inspection, Joe is excited to see his crush, Ellen, and probably wants to impress her on the train to start a conversation. Joe approaches and starts a conversation. Joe asks Ellen if she wouldn't like to have a drink with him after her shift, but Ellen excuses herself, saying that she believes there won't be any bars open after their shift. To hide his broken heart, Joe continues his work after the awkward situation. The scene shows an image of the full moon as the train makes its way to its destination. Suddenly, a loud noise travels throughout the train. To find out the cause, Joe walks carefully towards his work colleagues to ask what's going on. The radio rings and the driver says they've hit something in the road and advises the passengers to stay calm and in their seats. Joe finds Ellen in one of the wagons and helps her organize her trolley. Ellen advises Joe to check on the other passengers to keep them calm. Meanwhile, the passengers panic. Joe tries to calm them down, reassuring them that everything will be fine after the inspection. Fortunately, the driver discovers that they have hit a wild deer that is now stuck in the wheels of the train. The driver tries to remove the deer from the wheels, but can't because it's too heavy, and suddenly he hears a sound behind him. An unknown, hairy creature jumps out of the bushes and starts attacking him. Meanwhile, Joe sees that the annoying passenger is smoking a cigarette. Joe approaches her and warns her that smoking is not allowed on the train, but the annoying girl doesn't care, so Joe takes the cigarette and throws it away. At this point, Joe and Ellen think that the driver is taking too long to check what has happened. Joe takes out his flashlight and calls the driver's name, but gets no answer. Joe calls the authorities for help, but they say it will take 4 hours to reach them because of the heavy storm. Aware of the information, Joe informs the passengers of the situation. The passengers are distressed and think it's ridiculous to wait 4 hours. They ask Joe if the driver could fix the problem. Joe confides that the driver is missing and he hasn't been able to trace any sign of him. The frightening information leaves the passengers even more astonished. While everyone is arguing, a man called Adrian, nicknamed Mr. Selfish, appears. He suggests that everyone get off and walk to the next station. Most of the passengers agree and start getting ready to walk. Adrian tries to open the door, but can't because he doesn't have the keys. Joe, doing his job as a guard, reiterates the train's safety protocol and says that all passengers should stay there and wait for assistance if something bad happens. He hesitates at first, but then takes the keys to open the door so that everyone can get off. All the passengers get off the train, planning to walk to the next station. Joe advises the group to stay together while he leads them to the next station. As they walk through the forest, they begin to hear sounds in the nearby bushes. Joe and Ellen volunteer to go into the forest to check out the cause of the noise. While Joe can't believe what he's witnessing, he sees the torn body of the driver on the ground. Fearing for their lives, they start running for safety. As they run towards the train, a loud howl, which sounds like a werewolf, is heard. The group arrives at the train door, terrified by the sound and desperate to get on. The old woman tries to get on the train as quickly as possible, while the werewolf approaches and bites her leg. Fortunately, Joe and the passengers help her onto the train, but the old woman's leg is already injured and bleeding profusely. The annoying girl cries, while the other passengers help the old woman by bandaging the wound. The group decides to stay as quiet as possible so that the werewolf doesn't hear them. After hearing the werewolf's claws scratching the train, Joe concludes that the monster has gone, as the frightening sound disappears. The group is relieved. The passengers think that the old woman's situation is critical and that she should be taken to hospital as soon as possible. Ellen advises Joe to call the authorities for immediate help, but when he tries to contact the authorities, he fails because there is no signal. A technician called Billy says he understands engines and thinks the fuel leak is the problem with the train. He theorizes that the line must have snapped when the train hit earlier. He concludes that they can't move if the problem isn't fixed. Knowing the information, Joe explains the terrible situation to the passengers. The old woman describes the creature as not just an animal, but a man dressed in wolf's clothing, representing a werewolf. Suddenly, everyone hears a noise on the other side of the train. Joe and the others prepare to approach as they walk carefully, planning to attack the monster. As soon as Joe opens the door, he discovers that it was just a passenger. They help the man and explain everything to him. The elderly woman begins to develop a fever due to her serious injury, while the blonde passenger approaches the annoying girl to console her. The annoying girl thanks her for the gesture and talks about her mother. A loud noise is heard at one of the doors, indicating that the beast is back. Suddenly, the girl's phone receives a signal and a call. She answers her cell phone and listens to her mother as she tries to tell her mother about her situation. The werewolf arrives and breaks one of the windows, then the creature pulls the girl's leg, dragging her outside. As they try to help the girl, they hear the werewolf's attacks above and blood begins to splatter on the nearby windows. The passengers scream in horror and to save themselves move to the other side of the train to avoid the werewolf. As the passengers panic, the older man advises that they should plan a defense to protect themselves. So they use the train's tools to create a barricade, blocking every entry point to the train. As the night deepens, the group conserves energy for the tragedies to come. Meanwhile, Adrian approaches Joe to console him, saying that if the werewolf comes back, they need to be prepared to live life to the full. He suggests that if the werewolf attacks again, they could save themselves by escaping outside and leaving the rest behind. Adrian describes it as a fight for survival. Suddenly, the old woman's health worsens and she vomits a lot of blood. Joe realizes that one of the group is missing. He goes to check and discovers that the passenger is trapped in the bathroom. However, before Joe can help him, the werewolf attacks from above and takes his life. Adrian plans to get off the train in an attempt to save himself, while Joe tries to get back into the barricaded carriage, only to discover that it's already locked. Fortunately, Joe manages to get back into the carriage with the help of the passengers. They hold up the barricade at the door, but the werewolf simply walks through due to its great strength. Ellen is paralyzed and Joe saves her from imminent death. The ferocious and hideous werewolf approaches to attack Joe. But Ellen grabs a sharp object and stabs the werewolf in the stomach. The werewolf hits Ellen, sending her flying and crashing to the ground. Joe quickly grabs an iron bar and attacks the beast. Adrian then attacks the monster from behind, causing it to fall. As soon as they knock the werewolf down, the passengers gather all their weapons and use them to hit the werewolf, seriously injuring the creature. However, the werewolf gets up and starts choking the technician. To finish off the werewolf, the Indian man takes an axe and hits the werewolf as hard as he can. Upon inspecting the body, Joe concludes that it is indeed a hybrid between man and wolf. Suddenly, Adrian remembers that anyone bitten by a werewolf is doomed to become one too. With this information, all the passengers focus on the injured and bitten old woman. The older man tells a story about a similar tragedy that happened long ago in the forest, suggesting that werewolf attacks have been common in this area since ancient times. Then the werewolf rises from the dead and howls. Joe grabs the fire extinguisher and uses it as a weapon to finish off the werewolf once and for all. In the next scene, a group of werewolves are seen in the forest. This reveals that the werewolf's last howl signals the others to take revenge. They see the old woman's body begin to transform into a werewolf. Adrian concludes that the old woman is transforming rapidly and grabs a gun, trying to kill her before she transforms completely. However, the older man doesn't agree with the idea of killing his infected wife, while Adrian is about to do it. The other passengers stop him and he then tries to force himself towards the old woman, hitting everything in his path. The passenger chokes the old woman in order to kill her, but Joe appears on the scene and knocks the man down, knocking him unconscious. To avoid trouble, Adrian and the old woman are tied up. The technician gets off the train to fix it with his knowledge of engines. He instructs the group on how he will try to get the train moving and how the passengers can help him. The Indian man accompanies him and fortunately, he successfully finds the leak, which gives the group a good chance of fixing the train. Suddenly, the Indian man hears a call for help in the forest and decides to investigate. With his flashlight, he follows the woman's voice and discovers that she is being devoured by a werewolf. The werewolf pack begins to pursue the Indian man, surrounding him and they attack him. The old woman is now transformed into a werewolf, and Adrian asks the blonde passenger to free him, in order to kill the old woman before she transforms completely. Meanwhile, the technician successfully repairs the wires on the train. However, the werewolf pack is now surrounding the entire site. The technician sees the werewolves approaching, but fortunately they move away. Meanwhile, the old woman behaves differently and is now completely transformed into a werewolf. With her strength, she manages to break the ropes and free herself. Suddenly, a werewolf appears at the window and pulls the blonde passenger out. Adrian grabs his tool and kicks the passenger off the train. The blonde passenger is now trapped in the forest, awaiting her imminent demise. Adrian attacks the old woman from behind, causing her to fall. However, the older man gets angry and attacks him. The elderly werewolf no longer recognizes her husband and bites him on the neck, causing blood to splatter in all directions. She then tries to attack Adrian. The train suddenly stops, sabotaging the only hope they have. Joe saves Adrian when he stabs the elderly werewolf in the back with a spear. Angry, Joe tries to attack Adrian, but Ellen stops him. Meanwhile, the werewolf pack gets on the train. Joe builds a barricade to stop the werewolves getting close. He plans to leave and escape, but Adrian attacks him and the two start fighting. Ellen takes a sharp object and uses it to force Adrian to leave them alone. The werewolves arrive at the carriage and Adrian takes advantage of the distraction to get the key from the train and run out, leaving Joe and Ellen locked in. The three werewolves approach them. Fortunately, Billy arrives to save them. The technician brings a Molotov cocktail and throws it at one of the werewolves, causing it to burn. As Billy drives away the beasts, Ellen forces the doors open for them to escape. She and Joe jump from the train, but unfortunately Billy is grabbed by the werewolf and dies. The two then run for their lives through the forest to escape the beasts chasing them. Suddenly, Joe decides to stay behind and distract the werewolves. Before facing the beasts, he kisses his passion for the last time. Crying, she runs away as fast as she can. Although Joe fights bravely, he is simply overpowered by the three werewolves. One of the werewolves knocks him down. He takes a sharp object to fight back and stabs the werewolf in the stomach. However, Joe is defeated when the werewolf bites his neck. The scene quickly switches to the train station, with Ellen all bloodied up but already safe. On the other hand, Adrian is lost in the forest, and we finally see him come face to face with the newly transformed werewolf Joe, while the others just watch him being finished off.